हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ संजय उटगे, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इंजीनियरिंग, वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सोलापुर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस हाफवे रेक्टिफायर लर्निंग आउटकम। एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू एनालाइज halfway rectifier circuit efficiency, ripple factor and form factor. Guidelines: introduction, halfway rectifier circuit, derivation for efficiency, derivation of ripple factor, derivation of form factor, assignment, references. Introduction: what is rectification? The most popular application of the diode is rectification, conversion of alternating current to direct current. This involves a device that only allows one way flow of electric charge. This is exactly what a semiconductor diode does. The simplest kind of rectifier circuit is the half-wave rectifier. It only allows one half of an AC waveform to pass through the load. This is the circuit diagram for half-wave rectifier, having on the left-hand side AC input, then a symbol of a transformer. Primary is AC input is connected to the primary, whereas secondary is given to a series network of diode and a load resistance RL. Below is the waveforms. In the blue color, it is the AC input waveform consisting of train of positive and negative half cycles. When the secondary, top secondary of the transformer is at positive potential, diode will be forward biased, since its anode is positive with respect to cathode, and the current will flow through the diode and through the load resistance RL, and we are getting the output, that is V output, at the output side. So we are getting a positive half cycle corresponding to the AC input positive half cycle. In negative half cycle of the AC input, the diode, the upper part of this secondary will be at negative potential. The diode will be reverse biased, so it will be in reverse biased condition. No, it will act as an open switch. No current will flow. Hence, no output voltage is available across the load resistance RL. So, output will be zero. Hence, at the secondary of the halfway rectifier, the negative half cycle is completely suppressed, so we are getting a straight line 0 volts. So this is how we are getting a train of positive half cycles by suppressing negative half cycles. A type of rectifier, that derivation of efficiency, the ratio of DC power obtained at the output of the applied input AC power, is known as the rectifier efficiency. Let RF and RL be the forward resistance and load resistance of the diode. V is equal to Vm sin theta be the voltage appearing across the secondary of the power transformer. V is equal to Vm sin theta is the equation of a sinusoidal quantity, alternating quantity, where capital Vm is the maximum amplitude and small v is the instantaneous value. This is, let us consider a waveform, same circuit diagram with a waveform which is shown at the bottom, waveform at the output side, by considering an elemental strip of width dq with height I. Let us start for deriving the average and the RMS values. Efficiency: During the conduction period, its instantaneous value is given by the equation I is equals to V upon Rf plus RL. V is equals to I into Rf plus RL. As we know, V is equal to Vm sin theta, so I will be equals to Vm sin theta divided by Rf plus RL. When sin theta is equals to 1, the current will be maximum. Therefore, Im will be equals to Vm divided by Rf plus RL, where I is equal to Im sin theta. Since the output is obtained across RL, therefore, DC power output is equals to I square DC RL, or it is equals to I square average into RL. Now let us determine the value of average of the instantaneous value for half-wave rectifier. Average value can be given by integration of I into d theta divided by 2 pi. See, average is what? It is the area under the curve. That's why we are going for the integration. Integrate equation 1 from 0 to pi by putting the limits, that is from 0 to pi, because in this the full cycle is of base from 0 to 2 pi, but we don't have a area between pi to 2 pi. So we are integrating this equation number 1 by 0 to pi. So I average will be equals to 1 upon 2 pi into integration of Im sin theta d theta. I average is equals to Im upon 2 pi into integration of sin theta d theta is equals to Im upon 2 pi into bracket minus cos theta. So integration of sin theta d theta will be minus cos theta. By putting the limits from 0 to pi, we got the equation I average is equals to Im upon 2 pi into bracket minus of minus 1 is equal to 2 Im upon 2 pi, comes out to be Im upon pi. So this is what we got, the average value. I can find out the DC power. Now let us coming to the RMS value. What is RMS? It's a square root of mean of squares. So RMS value can be found out by the equation square root of integration of I square d theta upon 2 pi, equation number 2, and integrating this equation from the limit 0 to pi. RMS value, I RMS is equal to square root of 1 upon 2 pi integration of I square m sin square theta d theta is equals to square root of I square m upon 2 pi integration of 1 minus cos 2 theta upon 2 into d theta. So by putting the limits and solving this integration, we got the average RMS value equals to Im upon 2. Now the efficiency can be found out as average RMS power is equal to I square RMS into R plus RL. Okay. Rectifier efficiency is PDC upon PAC. So efficiency is equals to, what is PDC? It is Im upon pi bracket square into RL divided by Im upon 2 bracket square into R plus RL, comes out to be 0.406 RL upon R plus RL. Since load resistance is very very greater than the forward resistance of the diode, so RL upon R plus RL will be equals to 1. Hence, the efficiency comes out to be 40.6%. Conclusion for efficiency. This indicates that the half-wave rectifier can convert maximum 40.6% of AC power into DC power, and the remaining power 59.4% is lost in the rectifier circuit. Hence, the efficiency 40.6. In fact, 50% power is in the negative half cycle is not converted, and the remaining 9.40% loss in the circuit. What is conducting state of the diode in negative half cycle? In negative half cycle, The ID is reverse bias, so it will act as open switch, it will not conduct. Applications, half-wave rectifier is not so good as compared to full-wave or bridge, but sometimes we request these rectifier depends on the requirements. It is used for detection of amplitude modulated radio signals. For the welding purpose, it supplies polarized voltage. It is used in many signal demodulation process. Ripple factor equals to 1.21 is the ratio of RMS value fluctuating AC components to the average or DC value. The ripple, this is the formula for a ripple factor, comes out to be 1.21. Form factor is the ratio of RMS value upon average value, comes out to be 1.57. Acknowledgement.